We might love them, our dog population is booming, but are we losing control of our canine companions? More dogs are roaming, and in just the past year, dog attacks have increased alarmingly. But why? Well, tonight, Mava Moayyed's riding with animal control, and it doesn't take long to see the problems. But is it bad dogs or bad owners? Now, just a warning, parts of the story may be distressing to some people.
It's a confronting sound when man's best friend turns savage.
One dog attack number's too high, really.
Dog attacks are on the rise.
I can't sleep at night. I've got to try and do what I can to stop the sheep getting killed.
Are we losing control of our most popular pets?
Like, I remember seeing a lion on the ground going, "Mummy," you know, and thinking, "I'm gonna watch my daughter die in front of me."
Manukau Animal Shelter.
Right, we've run some dogs.
It's Monday.
A day for it too, hey?
Yeah, I think it's good weather conditions for roaming dogs.
Perfect.
Right, let's go.
Baia Te O's shift kicks off at 7 a.m. And in these South Auckland streets,
we've got a dog roaming there.
It doesn't take Baia long to spot a dog.
Oh yeah, what type of dog is this?
This is a Staffy Cross.
What's this? Come on. Come on, what's this?
This wandering dog isn't registered, microchipped, or neutered.
You want this? Thank you.
Every time you tie her out,
yeah, you're going to have to like keep proactively keeping her inside the house. If it happens again, or if you don't get the dog registered by tomorrow, then that will be a $300 fine.
Yeah, all good for her. Okay.
The father of five has been an animal control officer for 8 years.
Roaming dogs do have the potential to cause accidents on the road and then obviously bite people. People are sort of relaxed around roaming dogs and then that's an issue itself is owners believing that their dogs won't bite or won't be aggressive towards others and other dogs.
When you do get a roaming dog and take it back to its owner, what's the percentage who are, I guess, remorseless?
Between 60-70% of owners.
Under Aotearoa's Dog Control Act, owners must keep their dogs under control at all times, even when at home. Dogs must be registered by the time they're 3 months old. Failure to do so incurs fines of up to $3,000. All dogs except working farm dogs must be microchipped. And if a dog is found roaming, it can be seized and impounded by control officers. With the roaming dogs you're seeing, what breeds are they?
It'll be mostly pit bull crosses. But honestly, like with the high number of roaming dogs, we're just seeing different mixed breeds coming through.
These mixed breeds, Via says, aren't strays. The majority have owners.
So there's a playground there, which means that any dogs that are roaming hurt the kids in this playground.
Yeah, roaming dogs everywhere. We've had over 11,000 roaming reports.
11,000 reports in Auckland this year alone. It's a 40% increase on last year's numbers.
A lot of factors that go into it, I think. Auckland as a population has grown itself. COVID was another factor. Backyard breeding.
As we are talking.
Sorry, is that all right?
Yeah, go on.
Animal management, Via speaking.
Via gets an urgent report.
Not like overly friendly.
Oh, okay. But so you've
got two collars on.
You've managed to contain him, is that right?
Yes.
an American bulldog cross near a childcare centre. It's been wandering for 2 days.
Just arriving now.
There's a roaming dog.
There's a roaming dog here. And there's just a whole bunch of children, which is kind of terrifying.
Yeah, it's not a good mix. One of the poles, because I think I'll use that.
Luckily, today, Vaya has backup from his team.
Hello, buddy. Come on. Come on, you're all right.
It takes skill and expert timing. The dog is secured on the first go.
If you get it on the pole. Hold on. Good boy. Hold on, boy.
Good boy.
Good boy. You're all right. Up, up. Good boy.
How was that?
Yeah, that was another day.
that noise he was making, hey, sweetie. That sounded terrifying.
He was just more screaming because obviously he's just trying to get away. He's just real scared, yeah. But it's definitely showing aggression.
Yeah, it's like unsocialized.
Yeah.
Is there room for him at the shelter?
No, and our shelter that we use is at its capacity.
It's full.
It's full.
That's how many dogs you're getting?
That is.
Far. Come on.
Auckland's dog population has grown by 6% in the past year. But the number of dogs picked up by animal control has shot up by 22%. And roaming dogs are not just an Auckland problem. 3 hours drive down the Motu in Rotorua. It's the middle of the night, and Carl Hoffman is wide awake. It's icy cold, but the 84-year-old manages to shuffle along the gravel road from his house to a small paddock.
Come on! Oh, Nemeth!
I can't sleep at night. You know, I get up and I can't walk. I come out at night, Brian. See, they're all right now. That's all I can do.
Lemmy, come on!
I've got to try and do what I can to stop the sheep getting killed.
In the morning, Carl finds his sheep safe.
Carl, so tell me, where are we?
Tikatiri, and the neighbours down here have had lots of attacks on their sheep.
Over the past month, a pair of dogs have mauled and killed dozens of sheep in the area.
Never happened before. I've had 5 or 6 years my animals never had anything done. And some of the neighbours here have been fantastic and come out at night with torches to try and find the dogs that are doing it. And animal control have been out here most nights, and they're doing their best.
Carl's son, Kurt, has worked with animal control to set up a dog trap and camera.
Oh, wow. So how does this work?
You basically put the meat on the hook.
Okay.
And it triggers a mechanism down the other end of the cage that engages the whole thing to lock.
So very humane. Like, the dog won't be hurt if it's in this.
No,
it'll just sort of be stuck in this cage.
It will, yeah.
Last year, Rotorua Lakes Council received 163 reports of dog attacks on animals, 15 more reports than 2021. The Tikatiri community share their dog sightings on Facebook.
It's all the dogs that we think are responsible for the sheep attacks. Two large pit bulls, they disappeared before we could get a photo.
But so far, they're losing the battle. A neighbour's pregnant ewe was mauled to death while we were in town.
Somebody in the area knows those dogs. Somebody owns the dogs.
Who's she?
Kevin Coates knows a thing or two about dogs. He spent 17 years as an animal control officer in Rotorua. Before that, nearly a decade as a police dog handler.
Ooh, come loose.
Good girl.
What are the risks with roaming dogs?
It's an aggressive dog. It can get out a gate and attack somebody or another domestic animals. The main problem is the owners. Okay, the dogs that attack that old chap's sheep, if we had an owner of those dogs who knew where they were, or put the dog in the kennel at night, that he'd still have a sheep.
Good girl, on your box.
In his time on the job, he says, the worst behaviour wasn't from the dogs.
I've dealt with some pretty aggressive dogs, but I've had the means to deal with them. But with our lack of powers, with the owners, you know, I used to tell my staff, as soon as someone gets aggressive, back off.
Kevin says irresponsible owners need to be taken to court.
The victim has got a right to have something done. You know, people who lose stock, what have they done wrong? And if those owners were prosecuted, I believe that the message might get through. One dog attack number's too high, really, and they shouldn't, you know, dogs should not be in a position where they can bite people or attack stock.
On Carl's little Rotorua section, there are pigs, cats, a dog.
You could say I am a little bit of an animal nutter.
I can see that.
In a good way. Yeah.
In a good way.
Chickens and sheep. Carl used to have 5 in his flock.
How many of your animals have the dogs killed?
1, 2, 3.
He's now down to 2, Lammy and Rammy. And this one is still recovering from dog bite wounds.
Well, it just left me numb. Just left me numb, and that's why I get up a lot at night and just go and check on them. But if anything happened and I didn't get up, I'd feel guilty.
Coming up.
It went to bite my face.
Sounds like he was in hunting mode.
Oh, 100%, yeah. He was not gonna stop.
It's not okay. It needs to change.
Okay, gonna run again?
Sure.
This bright, giggly little girl is Sienna Lewis. Here, playing with her mum and dog Zeus, Sienna is completely at ease.
Okay, do it again.
3, 2, 1. Zeus, he used to be able to do rolly-polies, but now he can't.
Now he can't, yeah.
Zeus?
Until...
Sienna.
Yes.
Back here.
In the distance, something has just sent a shot of panic through her little body.
When that guy was walking down the road with that dog.
Yes.
Did that give you a fright, did it?
Yes.
When do you get scared?
When that dog's around.
You know, that innocence, it's kind of been taken away from her, and it's, I suppose, taking a little bit of her away, yeah. Sienna,
you gonna help Taki? Rotorua mum of 3, Kyrstie Lewis, always has her hands full.
Kids are 6, 3 and 9 month old.
You also work?
Yes, very busy, yeah. So, yep, 8 till 5, yep, on the clock, and yeah, and then from 5 till 7, it's them, and then from 7 till 9, it's me.
That's it.
Are you dog people?
We're very much dog people. We've always had big, gentle giants.
Boy.
Zeus is amazing. He's 75 kilos. He's 10 now, so I have to lift him into the cart if we want to go anywhere.
Zeus, you're the best, yes.
After a decade with this great Dane Mastiff, the Lewis family were ready for another addition to the whānau.
Zeus sheds hair everywhere, first of all. So we were looking for a wool dog. So that's where the BRT came from.
The Black Russian Terrier, or BRT for short. They're a powerful, large breed that can grow up to 76 centimetres tall and weigh 63 kilograms. They were bred in Russia in the late 1940s for use by the military. Their dogs created specifically to guard and protect.
We've had big dogs before, so the size and, yeah, learning to control a dog and training it, that isn't an issue.
Kyrstie found Black Russian Terrier breeders, Cherie and Rick, nearby in Tauranga.
We went up and actually had a look at the puppies. They had told us that the male was inside because he was unsocialised. And so we're kind of like, cool that they've put it away because that's awesome, thanks for making us safe.
she didn't think about it again until one December morning last year, Kyrstie and her two girls went to collect their puppy.
Luckily, Mum actually had said, hey, I'll come with you, and it was just going to be a nice girls' trip over and exciting that we get to pick up our puppy.
At the breeder's property, they were just moments from closing the deal.
It was really bright and I was trying to pay online. I was hiding on the side of the car to get some shade. And so, yeah, Sienna was 5 metres away, so not too far.
And you heard words, didn't you?
Yeah. Like, oh my God, he's out.
What are you thinking?
I might do a rainbow pattern.
Ooh, I love rainbow patterns.
Do you like colouring in?
Yes.
Sienna was 5 when she was attacked.
I was playing with a kid dog, the dog we're going to buy. I can remember as the dog escaped and had really long fur that was fluffy.
Wow.
It wasn't the mama, it was the dad.
It was a dad dog, was it?
Yeah.
And then what do you remember?
That it went to bite my face.
To bite your face? Was that scary for you?
Yes.
You know, that dog came to her and he stalked her like a cat. He didn't rush her and went to bite her face. And luckily, actually caught her heel, which whipped her face around. So he knocked her on the ground and then came and bit her on the back of the leg, took her, which lifted her up off the ground and bit her on the front of her leg. And then for all this, you kind of think, it's gonna stop. Like, I remember seeing a lion on the ground going, Mummy, you know, and there's just nothing that I can do in that moment. I just remember thinking, I'm gonna watch my daughter die in front of me and not being able to actually do anything about it.
Kyrstie says the dog bit Sienna again on her arm and hand.
I went to grab the dog, and seriously, no matter how much you kind of hit the dog or did whatever, it meant nothing.
Sounds like he was in hunting mode.
Oh, 100%, yeah. Had we not been there, he was not gonna stop.
And I heard that your nana was there too.
Yes, and she got my finger out of its drawer.
I don't even know how this superwoman did it. Opening up the dog's mouth, and then I went and chucked her in the car.
What did the doctors tell you about her injuries?
At the back of her leg, you can see all the intricate pieces. And yeah, that was 2 millimetres away from her femoral artery.
Seeing people and children coming into the emergency departments being attacked by dogs, you realise that there's that physical injury, but they also often there's an emotional component to it, and you know, made me realise that there was an issue. And you landed on your right side.
Natasha Duncan Sutherland, an emergency doctor with over 10 years' experience. She's treated over 20 dog attack victims.
Dogs have an incredibly powerful jaw, especially larger dogs. It doesn't just puncture the skin, it can also cause fractures, it can break a skull, it can kill a person.
The Auckland mother of 3 has led 6 studies into dog attacks in New Zealand.
Every year, there were 170 children who were hospitalised from a dog related injury. To me, that's quite shocking.
Proportionately speaking, the places with the highest number of dog bites include Opotiki, the far north, and Rotorua. The areas with the lowest numbers are Auckland Central, Wellington City, and Palmerston North.
They're definitely increasing. So we are now 8 times more likely to be hospitalised from a dog bite injury than you were 40 years ago.
Natasha says the exact reasons for the increase in dog attacks is unclear, but we do know who are most at risk.
Children are particularly vulnerable. They were more likely to be bitten in the head and the neck and face area, and that's just because of their size and their vulnerability.
It was the case of Carolina Anderson that changed New Zealand dog laws. She was horrifically attacked in an Auckland park in 2003. As a result, Parliament introduced the Dog Control Amendment Act, classing certain breeds as menacing. Those five breeds are the American Pit Bull Terrier, Brazilian Fila, Japanese Tosa, Togo Argentino, and Perro de Presa Canario. You cannot breed or import these dogs, and all menacing dogs must be muzzled in public, potentially neutered and microchipped within 2 months.
So the breed issue is a difficult one. We found that breed-specific legislation can decrease dog attacks by a small amount, but it wasn't a large effect.
What does the research show is effective in reducing the number of dog attacks?
Dog control strategies are effective, so increasing sterilisation to reduce the dog population, improving your fencing in private or in schools, introducing further leash legislation, and we need to address the education of dog owners rather than directing our education towards children who are not responsible for protecting themselves on this issue.
Dogs off-leash are a risk, she says, no matter how benign owners think their dogs are.
We've been here for about 20 minutes. I've seen around 10 dogs walk past. They're off-leash right next to the playground area. It's really concerning. You know, the children should be able to have a safe space to be in, and we know that there's problems, and we need to be able to do something about it.
Hey, yeah.
Back in Rotorua, Kyrstie found out that the local council were not going to prosecute the owners of the dog that attacked Sienna.
I was so angry. I just went back to them to say, did she actually need to die? Like, how were you not prosecuting something that is so clearly holding a dangerous dog?
Now, though, after reviewing the matter, the council says they're taking the owners to court.
I'm not going to waste my time kind of hating them, but at the same time, I would never accept their apology.
Nothing is going to change until we start doing something about this issue.
Natasha says one big problem is owners who don't report their dogs after they've attacked.
People say they're, you know, concerned about what effect it may have on them or what effect that may have on the dog as well. Then they're concerned about the dog being put down, for example.
Doctors are often best placed to raise the alarm, but
there's no formal notification practices for health professionals to report injuries by dogs when we see them to their local council.
It should be mandatory, she says, after every dog attack.
It is less about trying to get people into trouble as it is about actually supporting the victim.
In South Auckland, Vaya Te O has found the roaming American Bulldog Cross, a spot at the animal shelter.
This guy that we picked up today at the daycare, does he have a microchip?
We weren't actually able to check properly just because he's attacking the microchip scanner. If he is microchipped, we'll be able to contact owners or come collect the dog within 7 days.
No one comes to get him within 7 days. What's going to happen to this guy?
If he doesn't pass a temperament test, he will be put to sleep.
He'll be put to sleep.
The main reason is council is not going to want to adopt out a dog that's going to pose a risk to the public, basically, yeah.
Sienna Lewis's scars are fading, but the trauma will be with her for a long time.
What happens now in your tummy and in your body when you see a black dog out on the street?
I feel scared.
You feel really scared? How do you make yourself feel better?
I cuddle my mum.
I lay awake thinking about her lying on the ground. And then, when she's calling out to me, I don't think she understands the gravity of it. I don't think as a child you understand what that means. Yeah.
You're the best.
A dog is an animal. A child is a child. Child rights are paramount and should always be put first.
Well, the dog that attacked Sienna has been put down. The breeders are due in court tomorrow, facing charges under the Dog Control Act. As for the roaming dog that was caught in South Auckland, his owners refused to collect him and he was put down earlier this week.